Papa Squat, coming at ya. Gonna do a track from 1983. This is called Sexual Harassment. I'm sorry. I'm not sure. I think the band... Aw, son of a biscuit. Let's look at my thing here. The band is Sexual Harassment. Okay, so the group is Sexual Harassment. The song is K-I-S-S-I-N-G, which could be familiar to you. This is 1983. I didn't even try to look up any information on Sexual Harassment because I figured it would be nigh impossible to find a band named Sexual Harassment, as opposed to just being directed to the like National Sexual Harassment Hotline and all sorts of other groups. So keep that in mind when you name your group, as to not use something that, you know, is a generic term for something that happens frequently and is talked about frequently, and there are all sorts of different like groups to support. Like, don't name your band Mental Illness. You will never be found. Unless that's your goal. So let's check this out. 6 minutes, 22 seconds, Sexual Harassment with the track... God, I can't talk. With the track K-I-S-S-I-N-G. This did start playing when I opened it, and it is actually a recording of this record being played. So we're going to get to hear some nice vinyl, rich vinyl sounds. Kind of cool. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Completely random spacey sounds because 1983, Star Wars, all that sort of stuff going on, super, super popular. It was just everywhere, and especially in music. Kind of cool. I'm not moving, and I'm realizing it's because I'm sitting here thinking this is another entry into sort of the genre of songs of like a couple of line couplets about a particular topic, and then they move on to something next, and the next thing, and the next thing, and the next thing. And the, like, the best example of this, honestly, is probably 88 Lines About 44 Women, which is a song I just think is so, so cool. But there are plenty of others. I don't think this one is quite as good. It doesn't have the same sort of energy that you really kind of want from a song like that, because you want to kind of go from one to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, and it should keep you engaged. And we're only a minute and 15 seconds into this, so maybe it'll pick up, but I'm hoping for a little more energy as we get going here. And so far it's not at that level, and I think it really needs a little more oomph. But let's go. Place just as lonely as they can be. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. Sex is good when it's hot and wet. Go for all the love that you can get. Pure delight and ecstasy. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. Boy, this needs at least a 10% speed bump, and I would say as much as 20 to 25%, because it just needs to be a little more energetic. Thank you. I may have misread this song. This might be a song that they just wanted to experiment with some new toys, because now that's what this sounds like, is they got some new synthesizer, some new set of gadgets, and they were like, ah, let's make something cool. I mean, that's exactly what that section sounded like, right? Somebody just going crazy with a new keyboard that they found. So I don't know, it's a little hard to judge. I still don't think it's quite as interesting as a lot of other songs from this time period, but it is doing some funky experimenting, and I always love to hear people experimenting, so let's keep going. Also, I could almost swear to you that I had this turntable. I just noticed it's a Technics. I had the adapter in the upper left-hand corner. This might be exactly the turntable I had when I was in high school in the 80s. I hope they don't have sex like they make music, because this would be just about the most boring sex ever. Da 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 da. That little interrupty sort of sound that they've got going on there, that actually I could do a whole lot more of, do with a whole lot more of. Got to be the bass player doing that part, right? Somebody who definitely knows how to play bass is writing that part. That's a song, all right. Oh, check it. This is a single. See how fast the arm is moving across? Pretty cool. That was honestly not a very good song. I mean, for what... That's a terrible thing to say. For what it is, it's fine. There's a lot of experimentation, a lot of neat stuff going on in there, but it just does not hold together very well. It doesn't have the energy that you want it. Until they just start flicking around with the gadgets and toys, and then they're having a really good time, but the music is, or the singing is, oh my god, not engaging at all. Very much a turnoff. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. They don't have the energy. They weren't coordinated enough to do it faster than that. I find that hard to believe, considering how talented so many people are who were making music at the time, that they couldn't, you know, pick it up a little bit, make it a little more exciting, a little more interesting. I just, ah. Whew, that was a good one. Sexual harassment, ladies and gentlemen. There you go. I'm glad that one's out of the way. I'll be back with some more music. Hey, we're only like 150 subscribers away from 25,000, which is awesome. So if you're not subscribed yet, hopefully this video didn't turn you off, because I'm not being particularly nice, and usually I am very nice about the music, and I tried to say some nice things about this, but it didn't do it for me. It really missed the mark for me. And there you go. So stick around, check out some other videos. I'll have more coming. I'm going to do a few more today. Pop Squat. Checking out. Please like, subscribe, and share. I'll do some more 80s music. I do at least one song a week, so we'll do some in about a week. Have a good night. Bye-bye.